major change in military alliances is occurring, and somehow the mainstream media is not reporting the fact that the Atlantic Alliance, namely NATO, is in crisis, is in shambles. Why? Because Turkey, which officially is still a member of NATO, is actually involved in a friendly relationship with America's staunchest enemies, namely Iran and Russia. In other words, Turkey is sleeping with the enemy. And what is unfolding is an undeclared war by America against its NATO ally, Turkey. And this has been acknowledged by President Erdogan of Turkey, and he says quite candidly that we are at war. Trump has declared war on Turkey. And then he says the secret to successful states is their readiness for war. We are ready with everything we have. We are indeed at a very dangerous crossroads, but let us analyze the implications. Turkey has an alliance of convenience with Iran. It has an understanding with Russia. It is purchasing Russia's S-400 air defense system. It's opting out of the NATO air defense system. Does that mean that Turkey is no longer a member of NATO? Officially, Turkey is a member of NATO, but in fact, it is sleeping with the enemy. And in the meantime, the United States has waged a financial war against Turkey, and its currency has collapsed by approximately 40%. Now, what does this signify? If NATO, which constitutes the second largest power in terms of conventional forces within NATO after the United States, outpacing Britain, France, and Germany, if Turkey exits, call it NATO exit, what happens? The whole Atlantic Alliance is in a shambles because Turkey is the heavyweight in the Middle East. Now there's another dimension. Turkey and Israel have a long-standing, or had a long-standing, military cooperation agreement going back to the 1990s. And they exchanged intelligence, they had military cooperation, and this was directed against Syria, Lebanon, Iraq, and Iran. And we know that Iran is enemy number one in the Middle East as far as the US is concerned, and that possible aerial bombardment of Iran has been on the drawing board of the Pentagon for the last 10 to 13 years. But you don't wage war on Iran, or you don't even wage a bloody nose operation, if your heavyweight in NATO is now is now friends with Iran and has in fact rescinded its long-standing alliance with Israel. So that what is ultimately at stake is the collapse of what we might call the triple alliance: United States, Turkey, and Israel. That triple alliance has gone because Turkey has now aligned with Russia and Iran, and indirectly also with China. In other words, there we have a major shift in military alliances, which ultimately weakens the United States and weakens the United States and its allies, and which ultimately is leading to a restructuring of political alliances, not only in the Middle East, but beyond, with countries like Pakistan now siding with China, and so on. That is the state of the world today.
The Center for Research on Globalization depends on your support. To make a donation or purchase a book or DVD, please visit globalresearch.ca and click Donate on the menu bar.